I've had a lot of hobbies over the years, and I have absolutely dumped times into all sorts of pointless things. You've seen a lot of my work with a camera over the past couple years, but a few things that have become an absolute landfill of time are guitars, cars, and dancing, right? With surprisingly YouTube being a constant in there. I mean, I have hundreds of videos of me covering songs and, you know, learning how to dance. But we'll address that in another video. The point is, I have repeatedly found that I'm a hot pile of trash. Just garbage at what I love to do. The majority of the people at these events could walk all over me. They're so good at what they do. And I have dumped time into dancing, but I'm just nowhere close. And this March with cameras, I discovered I'm hot garbage when I spent a day with a professional camera crew.
You're not employed?
No, did I not tell you?
No, what happened?
I quit.
So what are you gonna do now?
I have no idea, dude.
You should start doing freelance stuff.
Thinking about it, I know I need to be more creative.
I've always said you're good looking. My guy is gorgeous, but boring.
But what a dud.
We met in a place where love is woe.
Oh, yeah?
We've fallen together, now we're whole.
I've never said that I wanted to go full-time doing this, but when I showed up, unemployed, with nothing else going for me other than my ability to wield a camera, it was humbling to see people that were very professional.
Prop master, right here, baby.
Get some dirt on that.
I don't know if I get.
Dude, I just got gigs of footage of you flipping off the camera.
All I want. All the photos I want to get back from you are me flipping you off.
Dude, it's gonna happen.
That's all I care about. But that shot is super
I left that night feeling like, man, that's the route you have to take to have success and make money with a camera.
And that's show business.
And I just didn't think I could do that. And for the first time in a while, just like dancing, I felt completely in the middle. Now, if I'm completely honest, I'm not garbage. I'm okay. When people hear me say this, they get mad, but I'm serious. I'm okay. I'm not bad. I just know that I am nowhere close to the best because I've been around the block and met a lot of people that do it a lot better than I do. You want to put me on a scale? I'm like right here. I can hang with some of the big boys, but I'm like, yeah, nowhere near the top. if you're the best at something, you've probably traded a lot of time with people you care about, or personal growth time, or time with friends and family, just for those extra hours to be the best. And I've put serious time into my hobbies. Anyone who knows me says, like, I'm spending way more time sitting at my desk editing than doing anything else, almost to the point where it may be an imbalance, but I know I'm nowhere close to the best. And that little piece of extra effort required to be the best and really truly great at something is intimidating. You'd have to trade some things, the ability to be well balanced, to be so specialized. And you have to decide if you want that. Do you want to be the best, or do you want to be well-rounded? Being in the middle can be the right thing. I think we are stuck with the image of success as the top, the absolute top. People who have dedicated every waking second to building a business or working on their craft. But that is not 100% of what it means to be successful. And being in the middle can be extremely successful when it comes to the rest of life, not just what you do to make money. I'm in the middle hard. And the only reason I would ever make it out of being in the middle right now is because I'm unemployed and can spend this much time making these videos. So, peace. What an opportunity to just be a total bum. Yikes.